Heaven and earth did sing my Creator's praises, and could not make more melody to Adam than to me. All time was eternity, and a perpetual Sabbath. Is it not strange that an infant should be heir of the whole world and see those mysteries which the books of the learned never unfold? The corn was orient in immortal wheat, which never should be reaped, nor was ever sown. I thought it had stood from everlasting to everlasting. The dust and stones of the street were as precious as gold. The gates were at first the end of the world. The green trees, when I saw them first, through one of the gates, transported and ravished me. Their sweetness and unusual beauty made my heart to leap, and almost mad with ecstasy. They were such strange and wonderful things. The men, oh, what venerable and reverend creatures did the aged seem, immortal cherubims, and young men glittering and sparkling angels, and maids strange seraphic pieces of life and beauty. Boys and girls tumbling in the street and playing were moving jewels. I knew not that they were born or should die, but all things abided eternally as they were in their proper places. Eternity was manifest in the light of the day, and something infinite behind everything appeared, which talked with my expectation and moved my desire. The city seemed to stand in Eden or to be built in heaven. The streets were mine, the temple was mine, the people were mine, their clothes and gold and silver were mine, as much as their sparkling eyes, fair skins and ruddy faces. The skies were mine, and so were the sun and moon and stars, and all the world was mine, and I the only spectator and enjoyer of it. I knew no churlish proprieties, nor bounds, nor divisions, but all proprieties and divisions were mine, all treasures and the possessors of them. So that with much ado I was corrupted and made to learn the dirty devices of this world, which now I unlearn and become, as it were, a little child again, that I may enter into the kingdom of God.